Hello, my friends. Welcome back to another episode of MTD-CNC North America. Today, I'm with my friend Robert, and we're at Harbeck, and they have one heck of a story about their investment in the Kiwa machines, how quickly they were able to pay it off based on a job that they specifically bought these machines for. So, Robert, thank you so much for being a part of MTD.
Thank you for letting me help you out.
Oh, absolutely. You have a great story to share. The testimonial about this horizontal Kiwa machine and what you guys were able to create with some of the lights out work. Would you mind sharing some of that with our global audience?
Absolutely. So we originally got a job in the shop here, and it was a very good opportunity for us to purchase some equipment. And the way it runs, operator free all the time, you know, it's a non-stop running. It runs for 24/7. We came in on the weekends. Within a year, it was paid for. All three mills were paid for within a year. It was like the best investment that we've ever done. It was awesome. These machines crank all the time.
That's amazing. Well, yeah. I've talked about Kiwas before and horizontal machining in general, and some of the benefits from going from a vertical to a horizontal machine are that the chips fall down, which helps create a better finish and oftentimes longer tool life. Have you seen some of that on the Kiwa with the precision of the Kiwa as well?
Absolutely. I mean, you can let these things run for a full month without any tool changing. The tools don't change anything. They don't change any of the tolerance or anything like that. Everything stays right where it's supposed to be for upwards of a month, and it runs really fast.
So, and speaking of your year of ROI, now, a lot of people will go, well, I thought a Kiwa was out of my budget, but you paid for this thing in a year.
Right.
You know, these aren't your commodity machine where you're gonna have 1,000 of them. Maybe somebody does, but typically, this is one you invest in for projects that you know it's gonna give you the quality and the precision you want.
Yep.
You guys paid it off in a year. That was largely in part to the fact that it was lights out machining, right?
Absolutely. The more we could pump out, the better. This was just run. And we had no issues the entire time. They still just run. That's all they do.
And the pallet change system. So there's larger pallet pulls in other situations, but you have two tombstones in this one that run for 6 hours a piece, right?
Yep.
And you guys run three shifts here. So every 6 hours, just pull one out. The other one's already ready to go.
It's already going,
so
yep.
So no downtime on changeover either.
Nope. No downtime on changeover whatsoever.
And based on that, you also have a guy that comes in on the weekend for about 45 minutes, sets up both tombstones, and then is out again.
Yep.
So you are literally running lights out 7 days a week
yep.
with three operations.
24/7.
And on top of that, if I'm not mistaken, that same one person can run five machines based on the ability to set up and then just keep going.
Yep. The way we have them set up right now, the tombstones, they change the blanks out. It's around about 10 minutes a tombstone, but 10 minutes, and then he has 6 hours to run other machines while he's doing that.
Wow.
Yes.
So we know that project paid for itself in a year, but there's also a separate project where you saved a good amount of time going from vertical machining to horizontal machining.
Yep.
Could you share a little bit about that?
So we had a job that we were machining four parts in a little blank, you know, four straight up and down. Because the chips fall down, we were able to rotate the blank sideways, get two parts, put more of them vertically. And what that did is roughly about 20% increase in, or decrease rather, in cycle time. And that thing just runs all the time.
Yeah, I like what you say about the decrease in time and the way you had it laid out before and the vertical versus horizontal. I think it's important to convey that by having a tombstone situation, likely being able to put more parts on the tombstone versus running, you said, four across,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Less tool changes,
yep.
less downtime on any of the all-inclusive parts that go along with running multiple pieces.
Yes. So, it's the same deal. One operator can run all the Kiwas and run other machines at the same time. So it's like free labor, if you want to call it that, because he's over here for 15 minutes changing parts, and then he's back to running machines again. Otherwise, he'd be changing parts in other mills, typical three-axis, he'd be changing them way more often, every 15 to 20 minutes, not once every hour and a half to 3 hours, whichever job we have in there.
Well, the last thing I'd like to ask before I let you get back to your normal day, as much as I know you love the camera, I think you're probably going to take my job.
Yeah, right.
I see a Fanuc control behind you, and
yep.
I know you have a lot of robo drills and Fanuc control. I'd imagine that universal relationship amongst a bunch of your different machines has been incredibly helpful to just going from one to another once you learn how to program, right?
Very easy. Very, very easy. We have a lot of different controls in-house, And we started getting into the robo drills and the Kiwas, and they all have the fan and controls on them. That's so far the best one I've used. I like those. They all very, very much the same. Even some older ones, but they're very, very the same.
That's true. I agree. And the last thing, and I know I think I just said that, but I'm saying it again because I want to know personally, because I know the relationship between you and OptiPro Systems is a great relationship. Whenever you have issues with any of their machines, are they always here to support you?
Absolutely. Anytime we need anything, they're right next door, so it helps. But they're always very helpful. They take any phone calls, any emails. They're very, very reliable when it comes to helping us out any chance they can.
They can darn near walk over, can't they?
They really can.
Well, thank you, Robert. I appreciate your story. Thank you for sharing this story on the Kiwa with MTD CNC.
Yep.
And I wish you success in everything you do.
All right. Thank you.